We're going to be talking a lot about formative feedback. We're going to be using Google Forms that really can be used with anything. On the activity sheet today, I've got exercises for three different kinds of getting formative feedback from students. This is different from giving students feedback and shortening up that feedback loop, though that is, a lot of the concepts are the same and can be reversed for that as well. But this is about, how am I teaching? Are you getting the information? And one quick way to do that is to just ask the students. So the three types: periodic, a couple times a semester, maybe once a month, you send out a survey and you say, hey, what's up? How are we doing? What happened to this last thing? Post-class, the muddiest point type thing. This is common with a lot of people in a, they'll hand out a 3x5 card. You can do it on Google Forms as well. And this shows how. And then the in-class, using top hat or eye clickers. We're figuring out how to use Google Forms and whatever devices people have so that they don't have to pay the top hat subscription or buy the eye clicker for $65 or whatever it costs. So that's still rough, that one. All right. One quick thing on why to do formative feedback. And these are several things that I culled from the internet. And I'm sure that there are other ones that you can talk to as well. But one of the big things was, I like to use it to remind them, we know in learning sciences, we know that the more often the students see the content throughout the semester, you know, as sort of a cumulative revisit the content, revisit, they learn better instead of, all right, we did today, leave it all behind, we're moving on. So the reflection of and revisitation of the learning outcomes helps to remind them. So in case in the beginning of the class they didn't get the, today I want you to learn, at the end of class, we can say, so today we wanted you to learn, and did you? And they can be like, oh, that's what the professor was yammering on about. Got it. Okay, did I learn that? No. Well, good feedback from the instructor to have. An opportunity to personalize. What hooks or applications in my life? So we can ask questions like, we talked about this concept abstractly. How does it affect the projects that you're working on now? How does it affect the dreams and aspirations you have in the field that you're entering? And we do that so that it sticks, right? Different hooks. If it's shared with the class, which is if the instructor says, here's the feedback, or please give us feedback, share your feedback anonymously with the class, now all of a sudden, Chris can say, I didn't get that point, but I feel comfortable in sharing that because James didn't get it either, and Sid didn't get it, and in fact, nobody got it, except for Amy. Amy always gets everything because she's like, knows everything, right? So that kind of perspective helps them not feel so bad, and again, great for the instructor as well. Number two, how well did the lesson work? Did they understand what I'd hoped? The other thing, Erica Halverson in curriculum instruction always said, so who's doing the work in the class? And this is a great sort of reminder. In K-12, we put a lot of the work on the instructor to always get at them and you know, did you do your homework and blah, blah, blah. We're still doing that a lot, but a lot, we're moving from the pedagogy side where it's being guided to the andragogy side where we're saying, okay, students, you're responsible for this. It is up to you, not up to me, to connect it with your life. And then the third one, adjusting instruction on the fly. This is very hard for a lot of instructors to do, and it's actually very hard for students as well. Because if the syllabus says they're going to do this, and then all of a sudden you go off on a tangent, it gets chaotic sometimes. So, for periodic feedback, here's an example that I use in my classes in the fall. And this is actually one, I think I sent this one out three times a semester. So we'll say, okay, week one, we had a game jam. what happened. And in that, I'll say, I'll remind them, what I wanted you to do was to be a little bit on edge and a little bit knocked off balance. Did I do that? And that way they can say, it's not just a, oh, I really hated that class, but the question isn't, did you hate the class? The question is, did I achieve the goals? Did I, as an instructor, achieve the goals? Did you leave the class feeling, you know, weird or terrible? And if so, that's a success, actually. And so it allows us to reframe the question a little bit. These aren't necessarily ideal answer choices, but your choices may vary.
Well, it's audience-based.
It's audience-based, and I'm very much a believer in capturing the personality of the instructor as well. So, that. Oh, the other part is always more thoughts. So, in case I ask the questions and they're like, this is a stupid question, I actually have other things to say about it than these five choices, I give them an opportunity to do that. The pairing of the very quantitative, easily graphed options with the very qualitative, and you have to dig in a little bit more, is purposeful, because it lets me quickly say, oh, a lot of them, you know, liked it. I can see that in the graph that shows up, but some of them didn't. And here's why some of them didn't. You know, there'll be a strongly worded one there. But quickly, I can see things, but I can also not. Simple things like choosing food or choosing some sort of class activity lets them get involved. And again, it gives this stuff like this gives them an opportunity to sort of have agency in the class. So it's not just the instructor saying, hey, I'm going to bring in pizza, what kind do you want? Or, hey, I'm going to bring in pizza, and I'm going to choose. It's, I'm going to bring in pizza, what kind do you want? I missed the whole thing about the muddiest point one. Drat. All right, well, are y'all familiar with the muddiest point concept? Who would like to explain it to me? James.
What's the one thing that you still feel that you understand the least of everything you talked about?
So at the end of the class, we often have this, hand out the sheets or the cards or whatever, and we'll say, what didn't you get? And that's a good way, while it's still fresh in their mind, to be like, well, I totally didn't get this, that, or the other thing, or I totally did get this, or the other thing was all great. The more distance, or if you put some distance between the class, that forces them to retrieve that memory of the class and access that. And cognitive science is telling us that it's actually the retrieval part. It's not encoding things, it's the retrieval of things that they need the most practice with. And so this is called distributed learning, where we keep revisiting the same concept over and over, and the more times that we revisit it, the more we have it. If you give some space between, you know, the end of class and when you ask, so you send out an email that evening, or the next morning you send out an email, or you put it in the course learning management system as an announcement, that gives them a chance to sort of forget it and then be like, oh, okay, so what is it that I had to do? And then they have to go back and revisit it, and that actually strengthens those neural pathways. So the third part is as a student response system, and what I'd like you to all do right now, I tried exploring this in 2011. I'd like you to open up whatever device you have and go to Bitly Mobile Connect. And it should work beautifully, though it should look ugly. So bit.ly/mobilecconnect. And if you're on a laptop, you should see something that looks like this, which was built on Google Sites in 2013, 13 or 14. If you're on a phone, it should look like, this one's not coming in for me. I use the Bitly, so it's not, so I don't have to give them a Google address, because, see, I forgot the I there. Giving them a bunch of, Mobile Connect is hard enough as is. I would actually suggest something even easier. Or put a link on your learning management system to whatever it is that you're doing.